ой, меня, и охай меня, и охай меня, и меня, и охай меня.
Hi guys, welcome. Today I'm back with another unboxing video of this Game Face airsoft gun I got. It's a GF. It's called the GFRS Tormentor Airsoft AEG. So it's electric, so it's fully automatic and semi-automatic, and two guns in one. So this bottom piece right here is actually a shotgun attached onto it, and it's slam fire. So if you hold down the trigger right there, and then you just slide this back and forth, and every time it goes forward, a bullet shoots. So you can basically, as it says, shoots as fast as you can pump it. So yeah, so as you can see, the box looks kind of funky because I've been using this gun for a long time now, but I decided to make a review about it. Since I've used it, I can give you an accurate review. And so this wouldn't be like this when you get it, but I just put it back in the box. So as you can see, it just has the same stuff. So the shotgun is 375 FPS, spring and adjustable hop-up. This, the rifle, the actual main part, is 300 feet per second. It's electric and it has adjustable hop-up also. So the bottom side is just basically just styrofoam. I don't know why Game Face, they always do it. The bottom is just styrofoam, and then there's a little cardboard piece on top. I don't know why, but so this, it opens. So these are like warning stickers, instructions, just stuff like that. Don't you just shoot your eye out, kids. Just stuff like that. This is a magazine. I have it already filled up. It takes up 500 rounds. It's a crank mag also on the bottom. So one, this piece right here runs out, you just crank it and it gets it from the reserve. Orange tips, obviously by law, to show that it's a toy gun and not an actual firearm. It says Game Face right there. It has a different settings for safe, semi, and auto, and when you turn it, you can hear a nice clicking noise. An adjustable armrest, I guess you can call it. So it adjusts to three positions. So it has normal, and then it goes, you just press this button on the bottom. It's not this hard, but I have it laying down, so second, and then all the way out. And so yeah, so just slips out the gun right here. So this gun is, it's not heavy. It's not really that heavy. See, I can just lift it with one hand. I'm usually right-handed, but I can lift it with my left hand perfectly fine. The magazine goes here. And the other magazine is separate for the shotgun. And it holds, so this magazine holds 500 rounds. This holds, I think, let's see what it says. I think it's like 25 or 15, just something little like that. I don't know, didn't say it, but so about how much it holds. The mag goes in like this, kind of curved like that, as you can see. The curved part, the part where it curves towards is the front. So just put it in like that, it clicks, and it stays in. It's pretty solid. So this has all the controls here, as I said earlier. Put it back on safety. This also, it has these little things on the side, as you can see, and you can press it down. So safety is on like that, and if you press it again, safety is off. As you can see, I can pull the trigger now. Now safety's on and I can't. And same for this, I can't pull the trigger when safety's on. It has rails, so it has one rail, one side rail, a top rail, and another side rail, and then another top rail. So this top rail right here would basically be for other like scoping attachments. This is a scope, a little flip up sights, not a scope, but sights that can be screwed off, so you can add your own attachments and this won't be in the way. So it flips up. As you can see, try to angle it, it's gonna be sideways, but here, I'll just do it like this. This is the best. So as you can see down the sight, and it has four different modes. So if you change, here, hold it sideways for you guys. There, so you can change the sizes of the sights. That was the smallest setting. This is big. Next it goes smaller, smaller, and then smallest, like that. There's just little like rolling thing that you just turn on the side. You can see right there is a little wheel type thing. This part is actually stationary, so you can't take this part off. It's the little part with the little pin right here, so you can aim. This is the hop-up for the shotgun, so you can just slide it. I'm not going to do it because I have it set where I like it. So this is the pump part, hop-up right there. The hop-up for the gun is actually, the main part's actually on the other side. It is, where is it? No, it's on the other side actually. What am I doing? Yeah, it's right here. So there's this little dial right here. So you're looking at the gun like this. It's this little dial right here. You can just twist it. And it doesn't look like it does anything, but you can see it has little letterings on it. And it actually does. It says less and more. You can read that. The release for the magazine, you just press this down. It's on the right side of the gun for right-handed users, so I don't know how user-friendly it is for left-handed, but it's usually a right-handed user gun. So this is the mag release, and then this just comes out. A nice solid grip handle here. Pretty solid. That again is the regular position. The back of this is also has grip on it, so it's pretty good. It doesn't slip off or anything, and it's actually comfortable. As you can see, that there's a little thing on the top. Usually you can open it up to put other batteries in it, but for this gun, let's see if it actually does that. I don't know. Nope, it doesn't do that. Yeah, just for looks, but usually you can do that. Alright, let's just flip back down if you want. You can also move it like this and moves it back and forth. And you can also, if you, there's a screw on the side, and as you can see, it can move from right to left also. And yeah, so this here, this does nothing, it's just for design. This also does nothing, just for the looks. Yeah, so I have the battery, it's actually charging right now. So it comes with the plug like this, just a DC wall plug for American wall chargers. It connects like this. It has one of these kinds of connectors, focus. Yeah, so it has one of these kinds of connectors, nunchuck style batteries, and just plugs into here, and it charges. So where you put the battery in is actually, there's these two little knobs on either side. You push them down, lift up on the top rail, and the battery compartment is here. So what you would actually do is, so you get the battery like this. It's kind of going to be hard to stand this up, but okay. So you get the battery like this. I recommend doing it this way. It doesn't matter which side, because one side is shorter and one side is longer for the the batteries, as you can see. So it doesn't matter which way, but make sure the connecting wire is facing out, so it's facing the opposite way. And then, oops, yeah, it's kind of hard to do this. Okay, I think I got it now. So make sure it's facing the opposite way, then you just bend it back over and you plug it into there like so. You just have to make sure you line up the right, one's a circle and one's a square, so basically you line it up. Oops, you line it up and it fits perfectly like that. And then you put the little rail back on how it was. The clip sides that you pulled up go second, so that angle is first. And then the side, that angle's first. Go in, get in. It's kind of hard because I'm doing it with a camera in one hand, but, or an iPad if you guys follow my channel. So that goes in, and then this side, all in a row. Maybe this side goes first? No, it's this side, for sure. So that goes in, and then, well, I'll be back when
so I yeah, do. So yeah, it goes in exactly how I was showing you, but right when I got the camera off, when I turned off the camera and started using both hands, it was way easier and it actually went in. So now, it actually shoots, since the battery's in, so I'm not going to take it off safely. I don't want to end up shooting my wall by accident. So, this is the gun. It's a really, really good gun. The performance is actually the accurate. It shoots accurately. Doesn't shoot inaccurately. It has two guns, which is really good, because if the battery dies or you're out of ammo and you're in a tight squeeze and you don't want to have to reload or anything like that, you can just pump this and shoot. And this gun works really well. The bottom gun, it kind of feels a little cheap, but that's what you get. This is like an $80 gun, I should say. It's like one of the cheaper guns for Airsoft. It has, yeah, so it's plastic. Most of it's plastic with some metal parts. I'm pretty sure that the magazine is metal. There might be some metal parts inside, but I'm not sure. This gun, it takes about 8 hours to charge, I'm pretty sure, and you get not the longest usage, but it's decent. It's not too short and too bad, but it's pretty good. Thank you for watching. Comment, like, and subscribe. Or I also should be saying, this, you can find the link to this gun in the description of the video. It'll just take you to the Amazon site. It's Amazon Prime, so for you Prime members out there, it'll take 2 days to get to you. And so you should click the link in the description, and it'll take you right to the site where it's the exact one that I got. And yeah, you can buy it from there, and it's pretty easy, so you should do that. Thank you for watching. Comment, like, subscribe. Go buy this gun, and goodbye.